Hi to all. Today we will discuss how to draw an involute of a circle. The given question is, draw an involute of a circle of diameter 50 mm. The diameter of the circle is 5 cm. For it, also draw normal and tangent at a point 100 mm from the center of the circle. First we do the involute, after that we will do the normal and tangent to it. So just I have written the given data. Diameter of the circle, it is 50 mm and radius is half in it, 25 mm. By using the compass, take 25 mm radius. And then take O as center. Do one circle here. After doing the circle, divide this circle into 12 equal divisions. As we know, at the center, angle is 360 degrees. We have to divide this 360 degrees into 12 equal divisions. 360 by 12, it is 30 degrees. Each angle is 30 degrees. Initially do one diameter here. From it take 30 degrees by using the protractor. Take 30 degrees here and then next 30 at the 60 it is coming. 60 plus 30 means 90. 90 plus 30 means 120. 120 plus 30 means 150. Okay, here we got these points. Okay, so join this point to center and extend that line within the circle. So this is the first part and extend it because circle is symmetrical about the taken diameter. And then this point to center. And then this point to center. This point to center. Then this point to center. So here we have divided the entire circle into 12 equal divisions. Each division angle is 30 degrees. Here mark the intersection points. I am starting from here. This is the first point, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10, 11. This is the 12th one. So here I am taking, this is the 12th point is P point, initial point. Okay. So after marking P point, at P do the peripheral length of this circle. So how to find peripheral length of the circle? We have one formula, 2 pi r, length of the entire periphery. Okay. So here 2 into pi into what is radius of it? So 25 mm, take in centimeters, 2.5 centimeters. So do with calci. 2 into pi into 2.5. This value we are getting 15.7 centimeters. So this is the length of the periphery. Okay, it is 15.7 centimeters. So at P point, do one line, horizontal line of 15.7 centimeter. So I have fixed the drafter at one of the corner. So at P point, I am taking 15.7 centimeter line. So just do one line here of 15.7. Mark this end point is Q point. Okay, PQ is the 2 pi r length. So after doing PQ length, so here at all the points we have to do the perpendicular line. So at 12th, O12, we did the perpendicular line already by using the drafter scale like this. Okay, this line is the, this scale is a perpendicular to this O12 length. Okay. Similarly, for O11th also do the perpendicular line. So fix a drafter scale to this line. Okay, O11 or 511 line like this. With this scale, do the perpendicular line. So here, do the line like this of some length. Okay. And we can call this line is a tangent to the circle at the 11th point. Tangent means this line is touching this circle at the 11th point. Okay, so this is tangent, one tangent. This is the another tangent at 12th point. This is the tangent at the 11th point. Similarly, at 10th point also, do the tangent. Fix the drafter scale here So one of the scale is coinciding with this, a tenth. Do the perpendicular line. It is a tangent. Okay, of some length. Similarly at ninth also. So fix the drafter scale here, and at ninth, do the perpendicular line. After ninth tangent, ninth point tangent, at eighth, fix one of the drafter scale here to 2-8, and then shift the scale at eighth point, and with this scale, do the tangent. After getting eighth tangent, at seventh one, fix the drafter scale here. At seventh point, with the another scale, do the perpendicular line of some length. Okay, and at sixth also, sixth we can do like this. Fix one of the scale here. At sixth, do the line in this direction. Okay. Now after sixth, do at the fifth. Fix the scale here. At fifth 5-11 line, fix it and shift the scale here, another scale, do the tangent. Now after fifth tangent, do at fourth one, fix this scale here at fourth point, and at four do the perpendicular line. After four, take this diameter as reference one. With another scale, do the tangent here at 3. Now after 3, at 2, do the tangent. With the another scale of some length. Okay. After 2, fix at 1. With another scale, do the tangent. After getting the tangents at all the points, divide this PQ length. PQ length just now we have calculated. It is the peripheral length of this circle. Okay, it is 15.7. So divide this PQ length, that is 15.7, into 12 equal divisions. Okay, 15.7 divided by 12. Do with calci. So each part is 1.3 centimeters. Okay, so here divide this PQ into 12 divisions. So here each is 1.3 centimeters. Mark the first part, 1.3 here. After that, this is a 1-. Take this part with the help of compass. Okay. Now divide it into the remaining divisions. Second part, 2-, and then third one, 3-, and then fourth one, 4-, fifth one, 5-, sixth one, 6-, seventh one, 7-, eighth part, 8-, ninth one, 9-, this is the tenth one, 10-, 11-, and the last one is, instead of 12-, also we can take. If you measure this value, it is also same. Okay, so here we have divided into 12 equal divisions. So at 12th point, so mark the entire length, that is 2 pi r length. Okay, so this point I am taking P12. So from P point to 12th point, it is this entire length I am marking, this point is P12. Now take the next length, P11 length. Okay, mark on the 11th tangent. Okay, next take P10 length, mark on the 10th tangent. Okay, tangent passing through 10. Like that, we have to mark all the length of the tangents. Initially, the entire length I am marking, it is P12. Here, at the 11th point, mark P11th length from P point to 11. Okay, by using scale also, you can measure, you can mark on it. Or by using compass also, from P point to 11th one. So, this length we have to mark on the 11th tangent. So, this one is P11th. So, this intersection point is P11 distance. Okay, for the 11th tangent. And similarly for 10th tangent, take P10th, okay, from P point to 10th point. So P10 you have to mark here. Okay, so mark this intersection point is P10. After marking P10, So here mark P9. Okay, P9 length. By using compass, P9, measure it. Here, mark on the 9th tangent. Here, give this intersection point is P9. Next, 8. So on 8, take the length P8 length. Okay, by using compass. So at the 8th point, mark this length. Okay, take the intersection point P8. So after P8, next 7th tangent. So on it, mark P7 length. P7 length. Do an arc. So extend this line for getting the intersection point. So this intersection point is P7. After getting P7 on 7th tangent, take 6th one next. So on it, take P6 length and mark the same length on the 6th tangent. Give the intersection point is P6. So after 6th one, take the 5th one next. Take the P5 length. Mark on the 5th tangent. Take the intersection point P5. After P5, 4th tangent. Take P4 length. 4 as center. Mark this length. Intersection point is P4. After getting P4, take the 3rd tangent. Take P3 length by using compass. So 3 as center. Do an arc here. Take that intersection point is P3. Next, 2nd tangent. Take the length P2. Length P2 length. 2 as center. Draw an arc here. This intersection point is P2. Next, take P1 length. Take P1 length. 1 as center. Just do an arc here. Take this intersection point is P1. Join all these P points with the freehand curve. You will get involute. So start from here. So this is P1, this is P2. Okay, join P1, P2. Next P3. I'm joining P3, P2. Next I'm joining these two. Next, P4, P5. Next, join P5, P6. So this is the involute for the given circle. So make it dark, this curve. So this is the involute curve. For this curve, we have to do normal and tangent at 10 cm from the center of the circle. So which is the center of the circle? This is the center of the circle. From it, take 10 cm on the curve by using compass. I am taking 10 cm. So this is the 10 cm from the center of the circle. Just take one point on the curve wherever it is touching. So here it is touching the curve at this point. Or that point is some M point. So at M point we need to draw normal and tangent. So for doing normal and tangent, join O and M with the help of scale. After joining OM, bisect this OM length. Okay. Bisecting means divide this OM length into two equal halves. Here we can measure the length, we can divide into two equal halves. So I am measuring with scale. So it is 10 cm. Take the middle point on it. Okay. So take the middle point of OM. So here we got mark, it is O1. Okay. Or you can bisect this arc by using the compass also. Okay. So O1 is the middle point of MO. Take O1 as center by using compass. MO radius, just do one semicircle like this up to the circle. Okay, it is touching this semicircle at this point to the circle. So mark this point is some end point. This point is end point. Join N and M with the help of scale. It is a normal to the curve. Join N and M. Join NM. Okay, it is a normal to this curve. As we know, tangent is perpendicular to this normal. Okay. So here at M point, keep the protractor like this. This is a normal and tangent is 90 degrees. Take 90 degrees here. Join M and this point, it is a tangent. I am giving the name here T, T dash. For the normal, I am giving N. The end point is N dash. Here T, T dash is the tangent and N, N dash is the normal. The angle between normal and tangent is 90. And mark the given dimension. Diameter, take any one diameter and mark the arrows. Diameter of the circle is 50 mm. And this distance of M point from the center is 100 mm. Okay. And then this PQ length is, it is peripheral length of this circle. It is 157 mm. Okay, and this is the complete involute for the given problem.